enable.
Hello and welcome to Making It Big Season 8. I'm your host, A.B. Ravi. Time and again, it has been proved that to a large extent, only entrepreneurs know how to convert adversity into opportunity. Let me qualify my statement. A few seasons back, we showcased the success story of the Delhi-based KRBL, the makers of India Gate Basmati Rice. In the case of KRBL, the promoters had to flee Pakistan post the partition, leaving behind their huge fortune. In Delhi, the Guptas had to start at ground zero. But in four decades, they have smartly bounced back. This week's story is similar, but it is devoid of any drama, pains or bitterness. But it underscores the point that you cannot keep a good entrepreneur pinned down for a long time. Lohias were running a very successful business empire in Bangladesh, but frequent communal riot there saw them relocate to Calcutta in 1967. It was not easy going, but they have proved that business is in their DNA by building business from scratch. Today, the Kolkata-based Merino Industries has emerged as one of the largest manufacturer and exporter of laminates in the country. Take a look at Merino Industries' story and you'll know how to convert adversity into opportunity.
Arise, awake, and stop not till the goal is reached, said the renowned philosopher Swami Vivekananda. This saying and teachings of Swami Vivekananda seem to have greatly inspired the Kolkata-based Lohias. So much so, their whole business edifice has been built around it. And the results are for all to see. In the last four decades, Merino Industries has transformed itself from a trading company to emerge as a leading manufacturer and exporter of laminates. Its growth rate in the laminate space has been astounding. In 1981, the company was producing 500 laminate sheets per day. Today, it produces 70,000 sheets per day. Merino, which has footprints in over 70 countries, essentially operates three divisions: surface solutions, food and agro business, and IT services. Both surface solutions and agro products are manufactured at the company's four plants located in Hapur, Uttar Pradesh, Rohad in Haryana, Hosur in Tamil Nadu, and Dahej in Gujarat. In the case of surface solutions or laminates, the company has the largest manufacturing capacity in the country at 168 lakh sheets per annum. This capacity, coupled with its own captive printing unit, makes it possible for the company to offer a wide range of laminates with more than 10,000 designs, textures, colors, and finishes. Effectively, it offers one-stop solutions to architects and interior designers. Sold through a network of 4,000 dealers under the brand name Merino, the company's products comprise laminates, compacts, pre-laminated boards, internal and external wall claddings, solid surfaces, polyurethane acrylic-coated panels, floorings, value-added compact products like restroom cubicles, lockers, etc. From the very beginning, Merino has carved a niche for itself in the marketplace by investing heavily in technology. Some of the products that have rolled out of its R&D are high-pressure laminates, electrostatic dissipative laminate, digital printed laminate, to name a few. Even though the company is a B2B player dealing with architects, interior designers, and carpenters, it has still managed to connect with the end consumers by setting up experience centers in Delhi and Kolkata.
We use Merino products in our projects. We have recommended Merino. Merino is a very honest company. It is based on an ethical core. And if you meet with the entire family that runs this company, and you will understand that in the individual interactions with them, whether it's the Lohias or the Singhis or all of them there. And I, for one, believe that if the management is so value-driven, then so will the products.
Hi,
face of the food and agro business, it was a natural extension to its potato cold storage business set up way back in 1969. Foreseeing a great growth opportunity, the company over the years diversified into farming, biotechnology and food processing. Its integrated approach has enabled the company to offer customers the complete range from raw material to finished products. Today, it offers vetted potato flakes and vetted instant snack mixes in the ready-to-cook market. Its third division focuses on business consulting and IT services. Here, it provides value-added services as a partner in progress. Effectively, all these three divisions have shored up the company's top line and bottom line. Thus, between FY15 and FY18, the company's turnover has grown from 972 crore rupees to 1,219 crore rupees. Likewise, its PAT grew from 113 crore rupees to 179 crore rupees. Interestingly, laminates constitute 90% of its turnover, while exports contribute 30%. Effectively, the Merino Group that was set up in 1967 by the late Mankumar Lohia and his brother has come a long way. But their journey into the business world was quite unusual. The Lohias originally hailed from Bangladesh, which was then known as East Pakistan. They were running a huge operation in Chittagong. In the words of current executive chairman Champa Lal Lohia, they were doing a turnover of 20 crore rupees way back in 1965. But frequent communal riots disturbed the Lohias, and so they decided to relocate from Chittagong to Kolkata in 1967. Initially, they got into the trading of jute and then moved into potato coal storage before entering the plywood and laminate business. Champa Lal Lohia recalls how the Indian operations came into being.
Because in Pakistan, the problem for Hindus started coming, you see.
Okay.
Yeah. So we thought that when we can't progress our business in Pakistan, let us go to India and try our luck there. Gave up the business there and came to Calcutta. Myself and my elder brother were there with our families, and we migrated from that place in 1967 from April onwards to November. Calcutta, we had a jute business, you see, jute from up country used to come to Calcutta, which we used to sell to the mills only, jute mills.
Okay.
That was the business. And then when I came to Calcutta in 1967 November, I was immediately transferred to Delhi, and we started this cold storage business in Hapur. 67 we bought a plot of land, and 69 it started operations, you see. We started loading the cold storage in 1969, and the first room was 50,000 bags of 80 kg each. Ultimately, the total number of cold storages were about 5 lakh bags, you see, 5 lakh bags, 10 times the what it initially started, and into several chambers, the 10-12 chambers, you see. In those days in India, we were the biggest potato storage in India, you see.
Having set a strong base in trading, the cash-rich Lohias decided to get into manufacturing. In 1973, they acquired a small tea chest unit in Assam and got into the manufacturing of plywood in 1974. The plywood business was a runaway success. This success helped the Lohias diversify into high-pressure decorative laminates in 1981. After that, there was no looking back. Over the years, Merino has been growing from strength to strength in spite of tough competition. Clearly, brand Merino has arrived. Interestingly, Merino is one of the few companies in the country which is seeing all the three generations working shoulder to shoulder to take the company to the next level. The company, which has imbibed the Western work culture and Indian ethos, is indeed keeping with the changing times. That ethos has percolated among its 4,500 employees. For instance, the third-generation Lohias have pioneered the manufacture of panel products like restroom cubicles that are finding increased applications across public spaces. On that note, it's time for a short break. When we come back, CNBC-TV18's AB Ravi talks to Prakash Lohia of Merino Industries about his strategy to stay ahead of the curve. Also joining us on the show will be Rajat Verma of HSBC India. Stay tuned.
Welcome back. He's a chemical engineer from IIT Delhi and MBA from IIM Ahmedabad. Under his leadership, the company has expanded its manufacturing dimension by producing high-pressure decorative laminates. I caught up with Prakash Lohia, MD of Merino Industries, at his Delhi office to find out how the company has managed to stay ahead in the market with its innovative trend and aesthetic solution. This is what he has to say. Take a look. Prakash, Rajat, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Prakash, when I begin by asking you, your family was traditional to potato business. And from there, you all got into plywood and then into laminates. What made you all get into manufacturing of plywood and laminates?
Potato business we started, say, 1968. And then we got a chance. And we came to know about a small teacher's factory available in Northeast near Tinsukia. And there was some understanding of how plywood is manufactured when we were in East Pakistan, Chittagong. So we took the advantage of that, purchased that factory in 1973. So that was our first foray into manufacturing.
Okay.
Right? And every trader, you know, he aspires to be a manufacturer one day, industrialist.
Yeah, true.
So that was our first step. And then what happened was we got good time. The time was good. So within a year or so, we could convert that teacher's unit into a full-fledged commercial plywood unit, producing plywood, block boards, flush doors.
Okay.
And this went on, and we went on expanding our manufacturing facility there up to 1996. In between, in 1980, you know, laminate or high-pressure decorative laminate, it has a synergy in marketing with plywood, because the channels are same, shops are same. So we came to know, and this is how the different types of integrations and different types of diversification takes place. So we decided to get into the high pressure decorative laminate, and at that time there was no factory producing high pressure decorative laminate in northern India. We were already present at Hapur near Delhi.
Okay.
Right? So it was easier for us to take a decision. And we started in 1981 this laminate manufacturing. So between plywood and laminate, there is a connection. And between potato and plywood, it was an aspiration to go to full-fledged manufacturing.
So how did the name Merino come about? It was not the original name of the company.
Merino, you know, is the name of a very high-quality wool. That's the ship of Spanish.
Yeah.
And wool is a consumer durable. Plywood is also a consumer durable.
Yeah, yeah.
So we named it. And then this is a small name. It has a, you know, jingle, touch of a jingle in it, easy to pronounce.
It resonates well with that.
And it got vindicated, because soon people started calling us Merino people, ultimately forcing us to change the name of our group as a Merino group.
The other thing you said, right from day one, you did not see any problem in that plywood business. So it was profitable from day one, you're saying?
Yes, because
what made that possible?
See, again,
the demand supply.
The external situations were favorable, and we could take advantage of that. We prepared ourselves, right? And what happened? Our good decision making was we didn't wait much at that level of cheapest making. The moment we got a chance, we immediately ordered plant and machinery and converted this into a full-fledged, very soon, within 1 and 2 years, we got it into a commercial plywood unit.
You entered the scene in 1970 after doing your IIT from Delhi. So when you entered, joined the family business, what was the scene like in terms of turnover, in terms of market, in terms of people, and what was the mandate given to you at that point in time?
I was directly connected with the manufacturing process, and the mandate given to me was to bring in technological edge, whatever we could, can do, okay, right, which can give us a competitive edge.
Okay.
And at that time, it was a very small factory. If I remember, our turnover was around 5 crores.
Okay, 1976.
And then after that, I spent up to 1978-79, I was there. Then I took a leave, I was allowed. I joined there under my uncle, who was looking after, we also joined family. So with his permission, then I attended my course in IIM Ahmedabad. And after coming back, by that time the family had decided about high pressure decorative laminate industry. So I was instrumental from the very beginning to write down the project report and initiate that project.
Today your company operates 3 divisions. One is surface solution, one is your foods and agro business, and third is IT industry. But 90% of your turnover comes from your laminate business. In future, will this ratio change? Are you betting big on agro and food business?
Of course, yes. That's what, because we have put in our focus on these 3 lines, right? Laminate is the oldest one. The panel division is the oldest one.
Yeah.
And agriculture, we are coming up very well, because in agriculture, we had this additional advantage of being centered in Hapur, which is a very big agricultural center, and we were in potato, and potato is the third largest crop in India, and India is the second largest producer of potato in the world. So we took potato, taking potato as the center, right, we have virtually created a network from farm to fork. So we are in potato seed, that is biotechnology, we are in the cold storage, we were instrumental in bringing potato flex first time in India, and we have gone up to the consumer through our ready to cook potato mixes, potato flex mixes.
So what is USP about Merino?
In Merino we have tried to synergize or combine Western work culture with Indian ethos, and that has given us a, not only in domestic market, globally also, this has given us a very good advantageous edge.
Let me get Rajat in, I thought. You heard Prakash talking about his journey, how they moved from plywood to newer businesses. So, when you sit back and look at this company's growth, as a banker, how do you see it?
See, I think, firstly, the story is very fascinating because you started off East Bengal, then east of India, and then moved to Hapur, moved from food processing to plywood laminates. You know, if you were to analyze or look at the company, one of the things which strikes you is the longevity of strategy, right? You've been doing laminates, plywoods, and you're a, you know, market leader in that space for a very long period of time. And the focus is clear. I mean, this 90% of the turnover, there's a very clear focus on growing that and on focusing on the right things, the right metrics. So, you talked about manufacturing. That was your background when you came in. That's encouraging because this is an area where quality was required in the country, and I suppose the unorganized market is quite big. You also need the distribution because this is widely distributed, and you need the end consumer to be aware of this product, and the distributors and the retailers, etc., will play a big part of it.
Okay. From 500 sheets of laminates per day some 40-50 years ago to something like 70,000 laminates are making today. There are some 4,000 dealers. We're present in from 50 countries. So what next? What's your dream now?
We are not yet number one in the globe, and we would like to be the global number one in the surfacing industry. That is the next foreseeable our goal in the present industry.
So, going by your own experience, what does it take to succeed in business when you look at your journey and your father's journey and entire family?
One is focused, clear thinking and concepts, what we want. Second is patience and perseverance.
Sure.
And most important is very honest and transparent business dealing, because that sustains the whole thing over a longer period, and you really gain over the long period. In business, right, it's a short-term gain. It should not be the focus. So this is what we have followed. This comes out very clearly in our, we have a motto, you have seen, under the logo we have a motto, economy, excellence and ethics. That also speaks the same thing.
Do you have any role model whom you admire?
Yes, and we have put it very clearly. Swami Vivekananda is our role model. We call him our patron saint because he symbolizes to us the combination, the synergy of Western work culture and Indian ethos. That is the greatest strength we can have.
Prakash, it was very interesting talking to you. Nice to be on the show. Thank for being on the show. Thank you, Rajat.
Thank you.
Well, that was Prakash Lohia talking about his strategies and game plans. These are the mantras the Lohias have implemented to build Merino Industries. Have a clear thinking on what business you want to do. Ensure honesty and transparency in all business dealings. Focus, patience and perseverance are a must. Finally, if you're looking for short-term profit, then do trading, not manufacturing. Interesting mantra, especially the one which says, don't look for short-term profits. Before I go, here's an interesting observation made by Winston Churchill, and I quote him. Success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts, unquote. The Lohias have shown the courage to continue after relocating to India. On that note, it is time to say goodbye. See you next week with another interesting episode. Till then, keep watching CNBC TV18.